you know?
Like no, just like we were supposed to be practice. Like
you were playing hide and seek. Maybe she's not.
Let's say she was supposed to come tomorrow for the practice, and then tonight sending me email and saying so I won't be able to make it. I'm like, fuck, what happened?
I'm stuck in traffic. See ya.
No, I was a little bit surprised, but she just left, didn't want to continue, but...
But you have a great new partnerships right now. I saw it yesterday. You know, tell
were
us
you about upset back then?
That moment, yes, because again, I was in a final and it was very good together working as a couple. But again, at this point, it for me also was stressful because I'm coming up with a new partner and she has no background. She has... nothing, just a ballet background. For me, it was also stressful how it's gonna take, and am I gonna be climbing up or I'm gonna be falling down?
So, how many hours you didn't sleep because you were competing in the first ever World Championship and you won, by the way?
So we had a competition the day before and we had yesterday's show.
I see, man, you're actually in a great shape right now. I saw yesterday, speed is good, you know. I mean, flexibility, everything is there. You are developing from year to year.
Vard and Inga only danced together for 1 year and they are already in the top three in American rhythm.
Your schedule, guys, is super crazy. And how do you deal with this? I mean, do you enjoy it still? Or it takes the fun out of it?
It's not easy, to be honest, but we like it.
Vard and Inga became Fred Astaire world champions.
Okay, but in this case, do you consider yourself lucky? Because Edward, he told you should dance with my wife. I mean, this is like, ta-da, present.
No choice, you have to dance.
Actually, he told me even before that, even when I was still dancing with my ex-partner. So I didn't listen, I was blind. So
I mean, it was really hard to like kind of imagine that from ballet world, you can, in this age, to turn into professional American rhythm. So it was kind of like hard to imagine, but
again, believing me, believing us, believing what we have and our personality, it makes the drive for me to you know what, yes, we can do it.
Difference is that ballet is actually on the stage and ballroom is on the floor. When you are on the stage, you completely forget about everything. You are in your own world and you're basically getting into your role and you don't see the audience at all. But on the ballroom, you need to be connected to your partner and you need to be at the same time connected to the audience. And in a ballroom, actually, audience is all over around you and you need to be playing with the audience and be more active. So that was really difficult for me to kind of overcome. After like doing rhythm, which is all about the hip action, the body rhythm, it's difficult to switch to ballet because in ballet everything is still needs to be hips.
Classical ballet.
So it's kind of like hard to switch the muscle work. But by the time you get used to it.
Yeah, now we can demonstrate you like how we can do in a point shoes rumba box. Let's try it.
Let's try it.
Yeah.
I don't know how that looks.
It actually looks pretty.
Quick, slow.
Thank you.
what moment of your life you found your way? Because I felt like since you the guys dancing together, you found your way even faster, and you kind of found yourself in rhythm, you know, in ballroom dancing so differently. So what was that moment? Maybe I'm missing.
Well, in a ballroom dancing, basically it was completely new for me. So I just started like a year and a half ago, so it was all new.
Really? Okay.
Yeah. So it was a little terrifying in the beginning. I was like, should I do that?
Why?
Should I
you
not?
Have nothing to lose.
Like,
I mean, why?
Yeah, but
you should have seen, sorry for interrupting, in the beginning, the process before the Emerald, because the Emerald was the first competition. She was like dressing, designing the dress, practicing. She was like, okay, I have no idea. Where am I going? What am I doing?
Yeah, it was terrifying.
And then throwing her in the biggest competition, you know, the Emerald.
I didn't sleep a week almost, yeah.
She was like, I don't know what to do.
Because, you know, he danced like for a long time and everybody knew him in that sphere. And it was kind of like for me, you know, I need to be good because he did a lot of, you know, work, and I need to, as a new couple, to present the best dancing, and it was like hard. I didn't know if I can do it or not after ballet.
Do you think, guys, the game nowadays, the game is changing? I mean, you work with different coaches, with great coaches. Do you think that from back then to now, and where you're heading, the ballroom dancing game is changing?
Yes, definitely is changing, and I feel right now all of us, everyone in the industry, trying to at least provide as much as we can at a real true American style. So I'm remembering myself right now back in 9 years ago when I was starting American style with John Allen. Everybody knows that he was a true American guy. So I think right now, these days, everybody trying to prove back the real American style.
So what is that, the back real American style?
Does to be more grounded, like to show more action, to show really the musicality, the rhythm. That's why they call it the rhythm. So we have to really show the rhythm of the music, rhythm of the body.
Which
so
part of the bodies?
Everything.
The toes.
The toes, yeah.
Started from the toe to the up.
In your case, it's the toes. Yeah.
It's the toe.
Do you think in this case of how fast you got into top three, do you think you creating your luck or you were lucky?
Okay, so let me put it this way. So in the dance industry, like as we all know, to be lucky is not working. So basically, we all these years hard work is already pays off. That I think this is the time was right place, right time, and the right partner. So everything happens in once. So that was the perfect timing that I had it, and we had it together, and it was right that time. Me trae fortuna y habla el idioma de mi corazón. So lovely she is, la niña for me. In my life, I need a change from city to village. I have my grandparents living in a village. I always love to go to the village because like 4 months in a year I used to spend there, and even now I do that because I do need a change because of the life in the city, you know how crazy and stressful it becomes. And then in a village I feel like who I am, and basically when I go to the village, everybody like I changed, totally dressed up differently and to become like a village boy, and everybody like, where is your family? Where do you live? I'm like, I don't live here. I just came here for my grandparents. They were like, but you talk the same accent and everything. I'm like, yeah, because this is my heart where it belongs. But again, like when I'm in a city, I'm a city guy. But when I'm in a village, I need those two changes.
Well, whenever we don't have a competition or some performance to do, weekends are the best time to kind of find out an hour or two, like, to do something for yourself. I like to read as well, okay. And I like to make some jewelry because it's kind of close to my second profession,
yeah,
fashion designer, so I feel like, you know, sometimes missing my profession and making some jewelry sometimes. And I have my company as well, Demetryan Art Design, yeah.
How this has came along? Because you were dancing the ballet hardcore, you know, and then ballroom dancing. So when, how this idea to become a fashion designer came along to you?
When I finished my school, ballet school, I kind of felt like I need something else, like another profession, but profession that will be a little closer to my ballet profession.
Okay.
Well, I think the fashion design is, you know, little similar, the dresses and the costumes that I can make for me, basically for my dance. So it was very interesting and exciting for me. So I decided to go to university.
Did you go here or in Armenia?
No, in Armenia.
In Armenia, okay.
Yeah, back
she
in Armenia.
A beautiful collection of dresses. Like,
yeah.
She's a very good.
I used to even compete in our university. Like I used to do collections, and with one of my collection, Chinese collection, I got the first place.
Wow.
In university, so that was exciting for me.
So do you planning actually to do something with this more serious here, or this is goals because your ballroom dancing is your first thing right now, professional, and this is kind of goes like a hobby, or it's still like you're trying to combine both?
No, right now it's like a hobby because I'm concentrating basically on my dance career. But I think I cannot dance all my life, right? Everybody know that,
yeah,
the dancer's career is short. So in the future, I think I can, you know, do it seriously and concentrate more on that. Why not?
At what age of your life you decided that you want to do this?
So it wasn't my choice, it basically was my mom's idea. So three of us, me, my brother, my sister, my mom took to everywhere. So she took me to soccer, football, tennis, ping pong, everywhere. So the second place that we went, it was dancing. So I tried it and I danced once I heard the music, and inside me it says this is it, and I just stuck there till now from 5 years old.
Actually it didn't happen like that I was like that's it, I decided to do this. No, actually my grandma really wanted me to go into ballet school, that was her dream, and then my mom decided, okay, let's try it. And then we went to ballet school, and then they took me, and I got stuck, that's it, all my life. And then, no, really, I felt like this is something that I want to do it. And I felt this is going to be my life. That's what I want to do for my, you know, whole life. I felt it's mine.
My mom and my parents has always been supporting. Always on my next to me and supporting, like, this is, if you wanted to do it, just believe in yourself and do it. That's what it makes me even stronger.
Then, I'm sorry for the question, but why are you doing this?
Meaning the dancing?
Yeah.
To feel that my life is fulfilled with energy. I'm happy with that because this is what I decided to do for my life, and I feel it's mine and it makes me happy. And when we share the same thing together, it makes me happier.
You have to really talk to yourself and just feel, is this is that or not? That's what happened with me. So I believe in it because I heard so many things about my dancing or energy being crazy, blah, blah. But that doesn't change me at all, even make me stronger to believe this is what I wanted to do. But when I heard when I was 15 that my mom sold when I was 7 her wedding ring to pay for my dance classes, that every time remembering that, even now, is getting goosebumps. So I cannot forget that, and I cannot even think to go back and to not be successful. That's and what my parents did for me, that makes me stronger and to go forward and forward as much as possible to make them proud every single day.
Sometimes you're totally tired, you're giving up sometimes, it's really hard, but when you remember why you're doing that, what's your goal, what's your vision, so it makes you, you know, feel stronger and go forward.
And what is very important as a professional, I can tell, like, you have to always follow the discipline. You
exactly,
have to make for
exactly.
you the discipline and follow exactly point by point, like go over to that.
You just cannot say, okay, today I don't want to do it. Whatever you do, let's say I'm practicing, I need to be 100% into my practice, not think about anything else. If I'm at home with my husband, with my family, I'm 100% here. So just to be in that moment and try to enjoy it. Otherwise, it's getting overwhelming.
What makes me happy? Every little things that can make me happy, that even if it doesn't make me happy, I make it happen to make me happy, because every little thing, it's very important in this life. Sometimes when you look at back or you look at the time, how fast is running, you don't appreciate, you don't see the value of it. That's why I try to value and appreciate every single thing that is happening with me every day. So that is very important and makes me smile that it's a beautiful day and it's gonna make it better.
At this point of your life, besides the first place, because we know that is not the ultimate goal, but what makes you happy?
Yeah, it's not about that actually, just that I have this kind of husband, this kind of person next to me, and person that supports me anytime, and I feel loved. That what makes me happy and loved all the time.
Yeah.
Otherwise, the rest is not so important. The rest is not, you know, it's temporary.
I needed three things in my life. If I have all those three things, I'm the happiest person in the world. So the first is the dance, as everybody knows. Second is the massage. No, sorry. Second is the horseback riding. And then third is the massage. So it can relax me so I can go over again. Dancing, horseback riding and massage. So it's the best thing ever. If it's no dancer, so then horseback rider. So that was the thing that I needed in this life, because they all balancing together. So dancing, normally you spend time with a lot of people. In a horsing, you just you and the horse, just you can talk silence. He doesn't has to bark you back or say no, this is not right or wrong. Just quietly listen and do whatever you want him to do. So, and then massage, just relax your whole body. Normally, it's even back in Europe, I love to travel. And plus, in my dancing, it becomes even better because it makes me to travel. Like even Sunday, if I have day off, sometimes, like at 2-3 o'clock at afternoon, I'm already like running around. What I have to do because I can't stand still. And then sometimes he goes like a grandpa.
If you want, you can come out and ride him sometime. I can't, but...
It sounds like we're talking about very depressing parts, like I like right now. Toughest moment of your life?
The toughest moment for me when I have to leave my family. It was the first time that I have to go to cross to the ocean without knowing where I'm going. And I got used to it. Actually, I didn't have any language. I didn't know any English words. I just know only hello, how much and bye. Why? Because...
how much and bye. Great. I mean, that's important part. I mean, this is how you will survive. I mean, yeah.
Yes. Why? Because before that, when we have performances in Dubai and Egypt, there is a lot of good shops there. So, you know, it's cheap. So we go say hello and how much. We pay the money and buy. That's how I learned. That's what I learned from there.
So after when you will retire, what your legacy in ballroom dancing will be?
We want to like somebody to watch us.
If you touch somebody's heart with your dance, I think that's the most important thing. You make somebody feel happy or sad or emotional with your dancing.
That's basically changing their life. That basically changing their mood in that moment.
As a legacy, I would love to leave my name and who I am and how I am, not just because he was such a thing, just remembering the personality, what kind of person I am. That's more value for me than just saying that he was the first champion or finalist or something like that, because being me, that's who I am, and I believe until now everyone knows me just because of me. I didn't pretend to be someone. The champions pass and come and goes, but the person stays forever. So this is the best part of the day. Perfect Armenian barbecue. It's the best in the world. In Armenia, it's hard to find it in America. It has to have a grape wood. So because the grape wood stays longer and gives the little bit different taste, so it does give the perfect taste that you will never forget it.
Okay, the meat is ground beef. There's a rice inside, cilantro, onion, a little bit oil and water to make it softer. And of course, salt, red pepper and black pepper.
So is it cooked?
No, it's not cooked yet. It's raw. So we place it on the clay plate. We fold it. Then we roll. We place it in a pot like this. I have a little bit left.
So the preparation is normally like a few hours ago, you have to put it in and marinate it. So you put like a red pepper, black pepper, salt, and then onion on the cut meat, and then you really make it to the meat to become a little bit red. And then you could put a little bit parsley. And then some people put some beer or wine, so to make it a little bit tasty. And then you always add water or whatever you add, so make it could be the meat has to be very juicy.
Who is more responsible for the cooking, you or Edward?
Well, he likes to do it, but I like it too. But when he does it, so I become a lazy. So. So as you're gonna see it, he's gonna be prepared already.
So he is more into the cooking more than you?
No, I'm into it, but if I don't have nobody that is me, I will do it, of course. But if I have someone that is gonna do it, well, I will help, but I can just sit and enjoy it.
We knew each other with Vard like from childhood.
So we've been together in the school for 4 years, and then we went to the opera theater, dancing together over there.
College, we danced together in the same department of Armenian dance and in ballet, and we went to army to serve together, and after army Vard went to USA and then he left me basically
by yourself and married. Okay.
Yeah.
And then he came to United States 3 years ago, so we still been attached. In a, it's not a friend, it's a family, it's part of the family. In the army there was a week about, we used to have like 1,000 drum, which is basically like $3, so we just have to arrange that $3, how to spend the whole week to go to the practice, after that to eat and to arrange everything. So we were able to do it, just whatever, even one penny, we know how to share it together.
What's your perspective, Eric? So when Inga started to dance with Varda, I know that was your idea, but were you jealous? Armenians per se very temperamental people.
Oh yes.
Oh yes. To be honest, if it wasn't Vard, I could not dance with anybody else. I think, yeah, because
you.
Because like from my side, like I would not dance with anybody else. Like with Vard, I feel like he's my friend and like my brother, and
yeah.
Feel like
he's
very comfortable.
Family,
he's
right?
Like family. Yeah, I feel like very comfortable even traveling or like competing. You know, it's. Ballroom world is kind of hard.
I can tell like this, like before when I was like very very young, I've been jealous. Even somebody can look at her like I was like, oh,
no one
like
can look at her.
My eyes and my my voice, my attitude can change like a tiger.
Okay.
Like already like that. But after a couple of years marriage, and you can live with that, and like you can see a lot of things. You, it's your wife, it's okay.
It's okay.
It's already normal. Yeah.
But how do you feel, Eric, when they're traveling and competing? Do you feel left alone? Because no, because you're here, or
yeah.
Or you cannot come with for any reason, like you have to work or something.
No,
like
what's
your perspective on that?
I completely understand, and I supporting them much as I can. Like I'm always FaceTiming, Skyping with them, and knowing every step, whatever they're doing, like everything, whatever they've been done, I know that, and everything, like whatever she's doing, I know that.
Whenever I'm gone, I put all the schedule, you know, the yellow papers, I put the dates and the schedule, so you never forget what you need to do.
Yeah.
Cooking and preparing everything, so.
Have you ever thought to do it by yourself, like, okay? I will take Inga and I will dance it. And
yes,
sometimes he jokes. I'm like, no. Okay, that's enough. One partner is enough. I'm doing with your ballet.
Yeah.
It's enough. I cannot do everything.
I'm asking, like, teach me
Vard's routines.
Yes, teach me Vard's routines. Maybe I can dance too. Like,
that's cool. That's cool.
Yeah.
I mean, you have a huge background, so I believe. So is it true that in Armenia you have to like steal the bride or something? How does this work?
It's not that you have to,
yeah.
If you want to.
So you didn't want to get married until you're 30 years old?
Yeah, at least.
Yeah.
What the philosophy?
I like that, like you have to have your car, you have to have your home, you have to
career
have your
and
job done, like career done, like everything, like, and then you have to marry. And yet you have to decide with who married, like a good marriage and all that stuff, and like, you know, how actually people can plan that. And then It's not works.
So I was the plan B.
If something happened, it's not going to be changed. Or you know that's how it's going to be. You're just going to take it as it is and just think over what you can do yourself to make it better. If it's possible, just do it, make it better. If it's not, just leave it the way it is, because it's not going to be changed. That's how on it makes me to believe in that, and just every day wake up and, like she said, think it's your last day of your life, how fully you would live. That's how I'm trying to do.